Let's talk about the future of Hackintosh. Apple will abandon Intel processor chips for its Macs in favor of their own ARM-based chips. It's still in a rumor phase, but most analysts count it as a fact already. So, what does that mean for Hackintosh community? Is this the real end of Hackintosh era? Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonaut.cloud and I help people to save money on their Hackintosh builds. I help them simply to build the perfect Hackintosh. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. Apple is using their own chips already in the iPhone and the iPad. And rumors says Apple will introduce ARM-based Macintosh next year, so in 2020. So should you, Hackintosh users, worry about that? Apple have done such a transition to different CPU architecture two times already in the past. First, when they switched from 68K to PowerPC, and the latest one was 15 years ago, when they switched from PowerPC processors to x86 Intel. And next year, it's gonna be a switch to ARM processors. So, when we are talking about ARM, you may think they are just some lightweight CPUs used mostly in mobile devices and phones. Sure, you're right. ARM processors have come to dominate the smartphone and tablet territory, but what about, I will tell you, you can run already these days a 32-core, 3.3 GHz ARM machine. I saw also ARM-based Gigabyte server with 56 cores and 224 threads. So we are not talking about some lightweight. This is real monster, real heavyweight. So, they can be used in portable devices and take advantage of their low power consumption, but they can also be used for really heavy tasks. So, there is no need to worry about its performance. Look at, for example, at the performance of the latest 8-core A12X Bionic, Apple's own chip, used in the iPad Pro. Geekbench single-core performance over 5,000 points and multi-core quite 18,000 points take it roughly on par with Intel Core i7-7700K. And we are talking about tablet performance versus desktop Core i7. Now imagine what performance could be revealed from desktop/server multi-core ARM systems like I mentioned before. So, what can we expect? We don't know yet if the new macOS for ARM chips will be as restrictive and closed system as an iOS is these days, but most likely yes. It's also still unclear how much will the new architecture be similar or different to existing ARM chips, or if Apple will make any restriction in their hardware like is doing already these days using their T2 chip, which is by the way an ARM-based chip. But again, I bet so. There will definitely be a transition period where both ARM chipsets and x86 will be supported in macOS for next couple of years simultaneously. For example, still quite fresh macOS Mojave was released just few months ago, but is still natively and officially supported on Mac Mini late 2012, iMac late 2012, and even on MacBook Pro mid-2012, so on 7 years old Macs. So, if Apple will transition to their own proprietary CPUs in 2020, there will be more likely again the same 7-year support for their older Macs, so for today's and next year's Macs. So support up to year 2027. Oh god, 7 years in computer industry is like ages in ordinary life. There could change so many things in 7 years in computers, so you don't need to worry about anything right now. And most production studios are still running some old macOS versions rather than the latest macOS Mojave. I still run systems 10.5 Leopard, 10.6 Snow Leopard, 10.11 El Capitan, 10.13 High Sierra, and of course 10.14 Mojave. In production environment, there is no need to upgrade to latest system currently available. It's risky, it's problematic, and brings more expenses. They rely and stay on verified and trusted workflow. So your Hackintosh would be running in few years as great as is running now. Who really needs that dark mode on macOS Mojave? I use the light theme because it's more polished and eye pleasant. Who needs those stupid stacks on desktop? I have all that crap disabled, so I could do without any problem all my work the same way on High Sierra. So, I'm personally absolutely not afraid of this transition. I rather welcome it. By my opinion, it's a very good move. I think this could be again one of the magical moments in Apple's history that can bring back the good old Power Macintosh spirit into our beloved Macs, which I'm missing so much for long years already. So, you just simply freely enjoy your Hackintosh build for about next 7-8 years. And also, in those years we will finally get an answer to the question if some clever developers will find some way to work around those restrictions like they did with current Intel PCs and even with AMD Hackintosh builds. So, let me know down in comment section what do you personally think about this Apple transition to ARM-based processors and if you are afraid of it or not. I hope I brought a little bit of light and calmer sleep again too. So guys, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Hackintosh friends.